Ooh, hot. Hey, Sharon Hornelstrom here, but you can call me Pajama Grandma. In case we haven't met yet, you know what to do, but hashtag, well, we haven't met yet, so you do not know what to do. But if we haven't met yet, go ahead and put hashtag pajama in the comments below. So I know it's the first time you're being exposed to the Pajama Grandma and the Daily Scare Share. Now don't be scared, because it's not a scary Daily Scare Share. It is a stretch your comfort zone and get out of the box, or the rut in my case that you might have been living in. I was definitely living in a rut, and now I'm trying to bust out of my comfort zone, bust out of that rut, and create changes and some fun and excitement and creativity and things that make me happy to be alive and to be living my life experience. So what I've been doing this year, not since the beginning of the year, I think since about the 5th of January, is one thing every single day that stretches my comfort zone, gets me out of that box, gets my brain thinking in another direction about what else is possible for me. And I'm using the book, Do One Thing a Day That Scares You. It's a little journal type book that I got up at the cabin to kind of prompt me and give me something every day to think about, to open my mind, open my eyes, look at things from a different perspective so that I can get out of my comfort zone and create the life that I want. And I want that for you too. Do you want it too? Do you want to create the life of your dreams finally? Well, it's going to mean doing something different, busting out of your comfort zone, and just stretching it a little bit every single day. So today's is, handy dandy magnifying glass, a sayings day, which sayings days are awesome. And I guessed who this was by, which I think is really interesting that I could even guess it. But it says, the happiest of all lives is a busy life. Oh, take that back. Erase. The happiest of all lives is a busy solitude. And that was said by Voltaire. I must have heard it in a movie or something, because I don't read a lot of Voltaire. And then it just says, today I, and a bunch of blank lines. So what can I do in happy solitude? What is something that you love to do on your own or by your own big self? All by myself, I love to cook on my own. I love to be in the kitchen by myself. It's fun to cook with other people once in a while, but for the most part, I want to be able to get around my whole kitchen without any impediments or people or dogs or cats. And I often have all of the above. That's why I love to cook in solitude. I love to read and meditate and think in solitude. I love to walk in the park by myself, which everybody thinks is crazy, but I like to go there and experience nature. Yesterday, I saw 3 deer, a mom and a doe, and they stopped on my path and just stared at me. I saw probably 30 turkeys, wild turkeys, tons of little rodenty animals like squirrels and chipmunks, lots of bugs. There's always bugs, but I don't think of bugs as animals because they're really not. They're just buggy. But tons of things and beautiful wildflowers and just the clouds and the sky and the sun, everything. I like to walk in solitude so I can enjoy those things, absorb those things, and let them positively impact me and my life and my day. So what do you love to do in solitude? I would love if you would comment below and let me know, what is something that you really are happy doing by yourself? Happiest, just being you. And I think that's the trick, is why we love to do things in solitude, is because we can 100% be ourselves, right? So go out, think of something today that you are happy in solitude, and maybe just do it for a little while. Wouldn't that be cool? So what could you do today that makes you delighted and happy and joyful, and you can do it all by your big self? That's it. Have a fantastic day. I will, of course, see you tomorrow with day 243 of our Daily Scare Share. Don't be scared. You got this. Pajama Grandma out. Oh.